The great white shark both terrifies and fascinates us. But why haven't we seen a great white in an aquarium? I'm Bob from World 5 List. Here are three main reasons that you won't see a great white in an aquarium. Number 3. They are crazy expensive. Money, the love of it being the root of all evil, and the preventer of things that you want to do because you can't afford it. Well, for institutions like aquariums, budget is absolutely something you have to think about all the time. You have to balance out what you think will bring in the customers while also making sure you don't go broke caring for the animals that are under your watch. Now, any species of shark is expensive to have, but when it comes to great whites, it's a whole different story. First off, believe it or not, great white sharks are actually protected creatures, which is kind of ironic because they're said to be one of the most dangerous things in the ocean, yet they need protecting from us. This is because even though they are feared, they're also hunted, mainly illegally, and thus precautions have to be set up to ensure that illegal capture and killing of great whites doesn't happen. To make a long story short, there's a lot of red tape that needs to be gone through in order to even think about getting a great white shark into an aquarium, and that's just the beginning. I'll touch on it a little bit later, but because of the size of a great white, you need to ensure that you have a big enough space to contain it. Since these creatures can grow very, very large, that's really hard to do, and yes, really expensive as well. And then you'll have to worry about cleaning it and making sure the water doesn't harm the shark, and need to reinforce the glass around the cage to make sure it doesn't break. It all begins to add up, and eventually, you're going to be spending more money getting and actually caring for the shark than you are making money via the people who want to see it. There are very few aquariums in the world that would even have the budget to attempt such a feat and get a great white into their ranks, SeaWorld being one, of course. They were able to get one once, but it didn't exactly go the way they planned. The point is, despite the obvious allure, there's a lot that needs to be done to get a great white from the ocean into the aquarium. And trust me when I say that even if you manage to jump through every loop and hoop to get it done, it never ends well. Number 2. You can't offer them the food they need. I want you to picture a great white shark in the ocean. Go ahead, think about Jaws if you want to. I don't mind. Now, what do you think the great white shark eats? The honest answer is whatever they can get, and that makes it so they have quite a large palette of food they can have. For example, they love to eat seals and sea lions, but not for the reasons you may think. It's not that they're easy prey, though they do alert the sharks to their presence easily enough, but rather the fat on the seals and the sea lions is really appealing to sharks. It's not unlike why humans eat cows, deer, and other things, because we love our meat. The great white is the same way with their meals as well. That being said, they also like to eat fish of various kinds and will even go after sea turtles. It just depends on where the sharks are and what they're able to hunt in the immediate area. Now, I want you to think about what creatures I mentioned here. What do they all have in common? If your answer was, they're alive, you'd be correct. But why does that matter? Well, if you have a great white shark in captivity, you have to feed it, but what do you feed it? It can't just go through fish pellets, and you can't feed it other animals in the aquarium, though that would be hilarious to an extent, because there are rules and regulations about doing such things. So what's the answer? Well, many aquariums have tried to feed dead fish to great whites, and it just doesn't work. Why not? Well, it all has to do with psychology. If you're a hunter and you relish in the joy of hunting your own food, you have a natural instinct to try and get your kill with your own two hands, or by whatever means necessary. Most sharks are aggressive predators that love the thrill of the kill, but great white sharks take it to a whole different level. They want to take down prey in a vicious manner, sometimes very epically, as great whites will sometimes rocket out of the water, grab their prey as they do, and then slam them down into the water so that they're stunned and can't escape the bite. The point is, they love to hunt and they love to eat live food, and aquariums can't offer that. So when they try to substitute it with things like dead fish, the shark doesn't respond or will actually wait until they're starving to death. Great white sharks actually hate previously killed prey, and this is a huge factor in why they can't be held in a cage. They have a primal instinct to go and hunt food, which they can't do inside of an aquarium. Some aquariums, though, have tried to put the great whites in filled areas with fish it usually won't eat, and needless to say, it doesn't go well for the other fish. Thus, the shark is put into isolation, which doesn't get any better. If a being like a great white isn't properly cared for, especially when it comes to food, it's not going to last long. And that brings me to the next most harrowing point on my list. Number 1. They die in captivity. But before we get to number 1, if you're enjoying this video, make sure you're subscribed and have your notifications turned on, because I'd love to bring you more awesome videos like this one in the future. Now, there are many mysteries when it comes to aquatic life. That much is known, but sometimes things can't be revealed about certain creatures until they're caught and put into captivity. Now, when you go to certain aquariums, you'll likely see sharks, but you won't see a great white shark, because they literally cannot live in captivity, because if you try to make them, they're going to die. Now, when I say they die, I don't mean they'll die off eventually after a long period of time. It's actually quite the opposite. They'll actually die rather quickly once they're put into a cage-like environment. For example, SeaWorld once had a great white shark at their aquarium, and it got a whole lot of buzz and hype. People actually flocked to go and see it, and you can't blame them for something like that. Yet, not 16 days after putting the shark into the cage, it perished. It was documented as not eating much food and would ram itself against the windows to try and break out, or potentially hurt itself. Nobody really knows for sure. As sad as it may seem, those 16 days were a record for a long time of how a great white could survive in captivity. Just think about that. A monster of a creature, a being that has caused terror and fear in swimmers all over the world, one of the deadliest predators in the waters today, and yet when it gets put into a cage, it can't survive. Or just simply won't. There's been some small progress on keeping them alive. One baby great white was once caught and raised in captivity and lasted about 6 months. A full-grown female great white was once kept alive for 44 days. But all of the results in the end were still the same. They did not survive in captivity. But why? Well, it's hard for them to live there. I touched on some of the aspects of the previous entries on this list. One of the big ones is space. Now, if you think about what's in an aquarium, more times than not, you're dealing with smaller fish and aquatic creatures. Notice that there are only a few dolphins, maybe a single whale in most outdoor water aquariums. That's because these creatures are so big that they need their massive own space. And as I noted earlier, it costs a lot of money. Now just imagine a great white shark, a fish, yeah, sharks are fish, that can grow over to 20 feet long. Try making and then maintaining an area that would contain such a fish. Well, it's not going to be easy. Many have theorized that there's a psychological reason for the death as well. Quite simply put, sharks can get really depressed when they're in captivity, like an aquarium. But why? Well, sharks are constantly moving. They actually need to do so in order to survive, as moving through water allows air to pass through their gills. As such, the great white is in a constant state of motion, and in the ocean, there's no worry about that. However, in an aquarium, there's a limited amount of space to travel. Scientists also think that the sharks not only know this when they're in captivity, but that they actually hate it. Great whites in captivity are known to be recklessly aggressive and will actually ignore food given to them. All of these factors add up, and that's when they die. To be blunt about it, great white sharks are a species of creature that simply cannot be contained by man. They're meant to be free creatures, ones that can roam the oceans, hunting for prey without fear. They're meant to travel the world, not travel in an underwater cage. And yes, other species of shark do happily live in aquariums, and that's fine. But just as every human is wired differently, the same goes for animals. There's just something within the brain of a great white that won't allow it to be captured and contained for amusement or study, and they'd rather die than be there. A lot of research has gone into the great white being in captivity, and it all points to the same conclusion. You'll never see one in an aquarium for a long period of time. It's just not gonna happen. Thanks for watching. Would you want to see a great white in an aquarium? And what do you think about places like SeaWorld? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure you're subscribed, and I'll see you next time on World 5.